Hi! In this video, you will learn how to create this simple yet interesting animated rating slide in PowerPoint. The way the slide works is like this. Can you see here? You pick a parameter and then you say how many stars out of 5 stars, and it comes in with a beautiful animation. So let us start creating this slide right away from scratch. Before that, I am Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We share creative PowerPoint ideas to help professionals like you create engaging presentations. Here I am on a new slide. I've already written the title and the text elements. These are fairly simple to create. You just use a simple text box and write whatever you want to write on the left side. On the right side, we are going to have the rating system. First, we will create just the outline of the 5 stars, and then we will show the filling of those stars with animation. So let us go to Home, go to Auto Shapes Gallery. From Stars and Banners, you will find this star with 5 points. Click and then hold the Shift button down and draw the shape of the star. So this is our first star. Then let us make 4 more copies of this. By pressing Ctrl D, I'm going to keep this right next to the previous one and then hit Ctrl D again, again and again. Now we have the 5 stars, then let us pick up the rectangle tool and then draw a rectangle which is fairly large and draw it around these 5 stars. Let us right click and send this to back so you can see these stars as well. Now select the rectangle first, hold the shift button down and select all these stars and then go to shape format, go to merge shapes and say shape subtract. Now I'm going to fill this with white color. And then let us have the shape outline as black. Now I'm going to convert this into a picture. So right click and say cut, then right click and then paste it as picture. You can see there are 2 options to paste. You use the second option called picture. Now this is a picture. Now I'm going to crop the area around the stars. So let us go to the crop tool, which is in picture format, and then crop just about that line, so you don't really see that line. That's all that we're going to do now. So this is done from all sides. Now what you see here is the outline for the 5 stars. Now it is time for us to fill these stars. So let us go to the rectangle tool and draw a rectangle which pretty much covers the first 3 stars, because in this case I want to show that the rating is 3. So you can see that I have this rectangle, if when I send it to back, will cover these 3 stars, thereby signifying that this is a 3 star rating. Of course, you can have this in any color you like. Let me go to shape fill, and this time I'm going to use this orange color. Now we need to have these 3 stars filled with a simple wipe animation. So let us go to animations and say wipe, and this happens from left, and it need not happen this fast. I can always have this happen, say, for 1 second. Now, this in itself is an interesting one. If you go here, it is a 3-star rating. But to add a bit more of visual interest, I'm going to have a hand come and then move across these 3 stars, thereby filling these 3 stars. So let us go to Insert, go to Icons, and then search for Hand. I'm going to choose this one with a pointed finger. Let us insert that. Let us increase the size and then let us rotate this. So let us go to rotate and say rotate left 90 degrees. Now we have this hand starting at this point here. Now let us go to animations, open the animation pane so you can see what we have already got. We have one animation, wipe animation from left to right. Now let us have this hand enter the scene with a simple floating animation. And this is way too slow, so let us reduce the duration to 0.5 seconds. And then this moves from here to the end of the star. So let me add animation and say motion path lines and say to the right. And you can see that it goes all the way here. We need to ensure that the end point corresponds with the end point of the star. So I clicked on this red point, held the shift button down, and I moved it ever so slightly like so. Now this is the end point of the star, and this coincides with the earlier animation. If I go to the animation event and go to effect options, you'll see that there is the smooth end and smooth start, which is not really required here. So I'm going to have them both as zero. Let me say okay. And the duration of this and the earlier wipe animation need to match. So I'm going to move this one down and let us have this duration reduced to the same 1 second that we used for the other one, so they both match. And as you can see, this happens after previous and this happens with previous, which means this hand first floats in, and then while this moves from this point to this point, we have this wipe animation happen from left to right. When I go to slideshow, the way it happens is like this. Can you see here? We have the 3 points shown. Now, once this is done, we don't really need this hand to be there. So let us select this, add animation, and move it out with a simple float out animation. And this happens after previous. So in all, this is the entire animation. Now, once you have one element done, you can always select this, press Ctrl D, and then have this copy placed right next to the second question. And you can send this to back. And then this time, if I want to have 4 ratings, I click and select this area here and then move all the way till the 4 stars. And then I need to just extend this motion path animation all the way to the end of the star, and everything else remains just the same. So when I go to slideshow, the first one operates like this, and then once I finish explaining, I can have the second one operate like this. As you can see, these are simple everyday slides you use in your business presentations. But with a bit of imagination and clever application of the various tools in PowerPoint, you can really make your slides captivating. If you want to learn how to use custom animation like a pro, we have put together a short playlist of videos that can really help you improve your skills. So go ahead, click on the link and start watching these videos right now and improve your skills in PowerPoint custom animation.